crowded around the airport's main gate. Increasingly desperate attempts to flee the country after the Taliban suddenly swept to power on August 15th. President Biden claimed the U.S. had flown nearly 28,000 people out of the airport in the past week. Recent reports indicate the U.S. is struggling to not only provide enough planes, but to find destinations for the refugees. An executive order now brings some 18 commercial jets to join the effort. The president said a larger safe zone also was being created around the airport itself. Reportedly, at least 20 people have died at the airport in Kabul this week, some crushed by stampeding crowds. Here's more from the president.
We're under no illusions about the threat. I said on Friday, ISIS-K is a sworn enemy of the Taliban, and they have a history of fighting one another. But every day we have troops on the ground. These troops and innocent civilians at the airport face the risk of attack from ISIS-K from a distance, even though we're moving back the perimeter significantly. We're working hard and as fast as we can to get people out. That's our mission. That's our goal. And our determination to get every American citizen home and to evacuate our Afghan allies is unwavering.